Hi, viewer. I welcome you to Erim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I will be taking you through Geography Form 3, Lesson Number 13. The topic it is mass wasting. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudho. Welcome. Our lesson course today, we are going to look at the processes of rapid mass wasting and also look at the effect of mass wasting. We start by looking at the processes of rapid mass wasting. One, it is the landslide or the landslip. That is the first one. We have already looked at the other types of the rapid mass wasting. Now we are going to look at the landslide or the landslip. It is the rapid movement of the large mass of the earth down a hill. The water content of the material is small. So in this case now, the presence of the water content here, it is small. So the material that is large, it is that landslide or the rock. What causes the landslides? One, we have the steepening of the slope during the mining or rail construction. So there must be that steepening of the slope during the time of mining or even the time when we are doing the rail construction. Number two, we have undercutting of a steep slope by the rivers or the sea wave. It can also take place where we have the undercutting and then we happen to experience a steep slope either in the rivers or in the sea. That is the graves. It can also take place when we have the loosening of rocks by the earthquakes and volcanic activities. So when that rock becomes weak, the earthquake and the volcanic activities take place. Number four, there is the clearing of vegetation from steep slopes by man. But now human beings start clearing the vegetation on steep slopes. Number five, we have the thawing of frozen soils on steep slopes and the movement of the melted water down the slope. That triggers off the landslides. Then it occurs in the following ways. We have the slumping, or the one that we refer to it as the slump. This involves the tearing away of rock materials along a concave plane. It is common on very steep slopes where large masses of rock, loose material, and vegetation rapidly move down a concave slope. So that is where it takes place. On steep slopes, and we have large masses of rock, loose materials, and vegetation rapidly move down a concave slope. It takes place when the underlying soil is saturated, making the surface rock to slide down slope. The overlaying rock breaks off and the rock mass slides downhill while rotating around a curved plane. So there must be that curved plane. Let us see how it looks like. You can be able to see there is the curve that we have already talked about and the way they are moving. They are moving and making a curve. That is the reason as to why we refer to them as the slope. The next one, it is the debris slide. The debris slide, or the earth slide, or the soil slip. This is the accumulated rocks, debris, and other loose materials which are products of the weathering may suddenly move downhill as a whole mass without breaking up and without back tilting. This means the movement here, it is horizontal. Horizontal movement. Then we have the debris fall. Loose materials on top of a cliff, steep slope, almost vertical, suddenly fall freely to the base of the slope. The movement of the material's debris is along a vertical cliff. It is sudden movement common in undercut banks of streams or undercut creeks. You can be able to see them. That is how they look like. The debris lines, they look like that. You can be able to see how they are moving. How they are moving. Then we have the rock fall. It is the most rapid of all the mass wasting processes. Individual rocks and boulders fall freely from a steep slope or a cliff. The falling material may be as small as sand grains or as huge rock blocks. So that is the reason as to why we say it, they are dangerous. Then we have the rock slides. This is a mass of rock slides down a slope. This one, it is a matter of sliding, especially over a lubricated surface. Let us see how they look like. This is the debris from. Can be able to see how they are flowing. They are just flowing down slope. Now, what are the effects of mass wasting? One, it encourages soil erosion on the landscape, especially on the islands. So there is that encouragement of the soil erosion. It takes place. Number two, we have the deposited materials may form moats that may block rivers and change their course. When the materials are deposited down there, they may block the rivers. They may cause the rivers to change their course. Number three, it can cause damage to the property, especially when we are talking about the telephone lines, the buildings, the railway lines, all those, they can be damaged and destroyed by the mass wasting. Number four, it can cause death of human beings. In case now, for example, rock falls on a human being, you automatically die. And even the earthquakes, we have lost a number of people through the mass wasting. Number five, it hinders transportation by blocking roads and railways. This is when the materials has been deposited on the road. Number six, materials washed downstream from fertile soils where they have been deposited. So it makes a good agricultural site. Then number seven, moats of debris have dammed river courses, thereby creating temporary wrecks. So we have the dammed rivers that result to the dammed wrecks. And number eight, it leaves a permanent scar absorb, resulting into blood dereliction. Those are the effects of mass wasting. Activity for today, explain four effects of mass wasting. And number two, state four forms of landslide. You can get more information from the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 3. You can also contact us through the SMSing us through the number. You can also get us through the YouTube. You can also get us through the Facebook. And also, you can tweet us. Stay tuned to EdenTV. Thank you.